Good afternoon, dear students. Today we will start the carbohydrate digestion and absorption. In last class, we have completed the properties of monosaccharide as well as disaccharides. Today we will discuss the carbohydrate digestion and absorption. Disaccharides and starches are digested to monosaccharide. Disaccharide and monosaccharides are converted into the monosaccharide. Polysaccharide and disaccharide are converted into the monosaccharide. Monosaccharides are easily absorbed. Fiber passes through the GIT and undigested. The fibers and they are passed through the GIT and they are undigested. They act as a bulking agent. We have seen that the starch is formed from the amylose and amylopectin. So amylose in presence of amylase enzyme that is present in the mouth in the tylen similar chains, it convert the amylopectins in a smaller chain. Carbohydrate particularly starch is a polymer consists of amylose and amylopectin. So in presence of salivary amylase, they are converted into the small parts. In mouth, salivary glands release the salivary amylase, which hydrolyzes amylose and amylopectin into the smaller chain of carbohydrate. Smaller chain. Amylopectin 1,6 linkage bhi hai, aur amylose na 1,4 linkage akeli hai. So it converts into the smaller chain. Amylose intestine no further digestion of carbohydrate. Amylopectin, no further digestion. The acidity of stomach inactivates the salivary amylase. Thus, very little digestion of carbohydrate occurs in the stomach. Stomach may, because of the hydrochloric acid presence, activity of amylase is stopped or reduced. So there is no digestion of carbohydrate in the stomach. Pancreas releases the pancreatic amylase into the small intestine, which hydrolyzes the amylose, amylopectin, and smaller chain of carbohydrate into the maltose. Ye maltose se bane hai, so ye converts into the maltose. Amylose, short chain of carbohydrate, pancreatic amylase hota, there are two types of salivary amylase and pancreatic amylase convert into the maltose. And also amylopectin, short chain of carbohydrate, pancreatic amylase into the maltose. The all disaccharides are broken down to monosaccharide, glucose, fructose, and galactose with the help of enzyme located in the lining of digestive tract. Maltase, for example, maltose in presence of the maltase enzyme is converted into the glucose. And sucrose in presence of sucrase enzyme into the fructose and glucose. Lactose in presence of lactase enzyme, galactose and glucose. Similarly, maltose in presence of maltase enzyme in carbohydrate into the glucose. Absorption of carbohydrate, how absorption, this is we have seen the digestion, how the absorption of carbohydrate takes place. Once digested to the monosaccharide, absorbed through the intestinal cell mucosa, transported to the liver via the portal vein, metabolic needs direct feed of the monosaccharide. Galactose and fructose क्या करते हैं? Used by the liver for the energy. And secondly, converted to the glucose. And what about the glucose? Glucose used for the energy, converted to glycogen through the glycogenesis, converted to glycerol and fatty acid for storage into adipoweights. Adipoweights. Glucose stored in the liver and muscles as glycogen. A. Dietary carbohydrates from the stomach delivered to small intestine. Glucose and other monosaccharide transported to the liver. Liver mein pahunche glucose, glycogen. C. Blood levels of glucose maintained for the brain and other body cells. D. ग्लाइकोजन मसल्स में ग्लाइकोजन प्लस एनर्जी ग्लूकोज ग्लूकोज ट्रांसपोर्टेड टू द मसल्स सो दिस द टोटल एक्टिविटी ऑफ ग्लूकोज इज स्टोर्ड इन लिवर एंड मसल्स एज ग्लाइकोजन क्विक रिव्यू देख सकते हैं डाइजेशन ऑफ कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स बिगिंस इन द माउथ मोस्ट कार्बोहाइड्रेट डाइजेशन टेक्स प्लेस इन द स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स आर ब्रोकन डाउन टू मोनोसैकेराइड फॉर एब्जॉर्प्शन मोनोसैकेराइड्स आर कन्वर्टेड टू ग्लूकोज इन द लिवर एंड यूज एज एनर्जी सेकेंडली स्टोर्ड एज ग्लाइकोजन इन लिवर एंड मसल सेल्स थर्ड स्टोर्ड एज ए ग्लिसरॉल एंड फैटी एसिड्स इन द एडिपोसाइट्स डिपॉजिट ऑफ लिपिड्स फाइबर ट्रेवल्स टू द colon undigested and most is eliminated from the body lactose intolerance what is lactose intolerance deficiency of lactase the enzyme that digests the lactose lactose ke digestion ke liye lactase enzyme chahiye if there is a deficiency of lactase enzyme then the condition is known as lactose intolerance maldigestion that is inability to digest lactose due to low level of the enzyme intolerance maldigestion resulting in nausea cramps bloating flatulence and diarrhea these are the symptoms of intolerance lactose intolerance functions of carbohydrates carbohydrates provides energy major role is to provide energy 4 kilocalories per gram maintain blood glucose level carbohydrate intake glycogenolysis greater than 4 hours after a meal glycogenolysis spare proteins prevent the need for gluconeogenesis prevent ketosis so these are the functions of carbohydrate number 1 provides energy maintain glucose level spares the proteins and prevent ketosis if sufficient amount of carbohydrate is provided then they perform the 4 important functions How to maintain blood glucose level? The goal of blood glucose is 70 to 100 milligram per deciliter. Insulin lowers the blood glucose levels needed for glucose to enter the cell from the bloodstream. Exception: liver, kidney, and brain cells. Second, helps convert glucose to glycogen through the glycogenesis. Helps convert glucose to fatty acids through the lipogenesis inhibit lipolysis glucagon increase blood glucose levels stimulate the release of glucose into the blood insulin and glucagon regulate glucose metabolism these both hormones are present in the pancreas first we will see how high blood glucose levels is controlled in pancreas insulin is active and it increases the absorption of glucose in the blood glycogenesis lipogenesis glycogenesis muscles and in liver in low glucose level there is a reverse process in liver gluconeogenesis formation of glucose is again reached to the blood and also the glycogenolysis glycogen stores broken down thus they maintain the glucose level in condition of the low blood glucose level how to maintain blood glucose levels epinephrine and norepinephrine increase the blood glucose levels these are the two important biogenic amines which are present in the ans and particularly sympathetic nervous system they are responsible for increasing the blood glucose level stimulate glycogenolysis that is the breakdown of glycogen into glucose and also gluconeogenesis that is formation of glucose from other non carbohydrate unit cortisol increase blood glucose level stimulate gluconeogenesis reduces uptake of glucose by the muscle cells third role of growth hormones increase blood glucose stimulates the fat breakdown for energy, reduce uptake of glucose by muscles, increase glucose production in the liver. So thus the level of glucose is maintained. Quick review. Glucose in the body preferred source of energy, especially in the brain and red blood cells. Adequate carbohydrate intake maintains blood glucose levels, spares protein, prevent ketosis. Teen functions karte. Blood glucose levels are maintained by two hormones. Insulin, which lowers the blood glucose levels. Glucagon, which raises the blood glucose levels. Epinephrine, non-epinephrine, cortisol, and growth hormones raise the blood glucose levels. Glycemic index classifies the effect of carbohydrate containing food on blood glucose. May be helpful for diabetics. Diabetes is a disease in which there is a deficiency of insulin, and thus the level of glucose may be increased. Glycemic index refers to the measured upward rise, peaks, and fall of blood glucose following consumption of high carbohydrate food, ranks foods according to the blood glucose. Glycemic load. Glycemic load minus adjusting glycemic index by taking into the account the amount of carbohydrate consumed in a typical serving of food. Factors affecting glycemic index: ripeness of fruit, cooking, processing, size of food pieces, amount of fiber, combination of food eaten. These are the factors which affect glycemic index: ripeness of fruit, cooking, processing, size of food pieces, amount of fiber, combinations of food eaten. Glycemic index and glycemic load. Usefulness of glycemic index and glycemic load for disease prevention and weight management is controversial. Fix nahi hai kaisa? Is helpful in educating the people about carbohydrate contents of the foods, portion size, and serving numbers. These are the important for maintaining the body weight. Dietary fiber helps lower the risk of bowel irregularity, obesity, heart disease, cancer, diabetes mellitus. Dietary fiber. Chronic constipation can lead to the diverticulosis and diverticulitis, formation of pouch like in the intestine. This is diverticulia. Prevention of constipation and diverticulosis. Insoluble fibers helps reduce transit time of food in the colon. Soluble fiber cells make stool easier to pass by increasing the bulk and softening texture. Dietary fiber. Prevention of heart disease and diabetes. Viscous soluble fibers helps lower elevated blood cholesterol level, interferes with the reabsorption of bile acids. Cholesterol jo hai bile se saath milke intestine it secreted into the emulsified with the bile and secreted into the intestine and maybe pass out with the excess in the through the feces. Thus dietary fibers slow moving viscous soluble fibers may reduce the rate which fat and carbohydrate are absorbed, decreasing level of fat in blood and improving insulin sensitivity, decrease risk of heart disease. Insoluble fibers has been shown to promote heart health. Viscous soluble fiber helps slow digestion and absorption, helping control glucose levels. Dietary fibers helps reduce the incidence of several cancers, decreases the amount of time cancer promoting substances spend in contact with intestinal lining, encourages the growth of colon friendly bacteria, reduces acid in the colon, helps prevent obesity, increase satiety and reduce food intake. Glycemic index ranks foods according to the effects of glucose levels compared to white bread or pure glucose. Glycemic load adjusts for serving size. Foods that contain high fiber are eaten with the protein and fat generally have a lower glycemic index. High fiber diet health benefits includes reduced risk of high fiber के benefits हैं, like they are helpful in following conditions: constipation, diverticulosis, heart disease, obesity and diabetes mellitus. What are your fiber needs? Here is a chart showing the need of fibers and supplying the grams fiber daily. 14 to 18 years old, 38 males mein, 36 females mein. 19 to 50 years, 38, 25, 51 to plus 17, 30 and 21. This is the ratio required, the fiber need. Importance of whole grain. Whole grains are very important. Number one, bran, high fiber, vitamin B, phytochemicals and minerals. Germ, seeds का जो whole grain का दिखाया है, germs containing vitamin E, healthy unsaturated fats, antioxidant, phytochemicals, minerals, vitamin B, endosperm contain starch, protein and vitamin B. Whole grain, whole kernel used, whole wheat flour we can use, then we can get these above mentioned things in the food. Only endosperm used, enriched wheat flour, folic acid, thiamine, niacin, riboflavin and iron added. Only endosperm wheat flour, not enriched. Carbohydrate source, best choice should include nutrient dense, low saturated fat foods, simple carbohydrates, fiber complex carbohydrate. Food sources of carbohydrates, grains hain, vegetables hain, fruits hain, milk hain, meat and beans. From the charts we can say fruits are number one, then vegetables, then grains and then meat. This chart shows the food source of other things may remain the somewhat different, but if we will compare only the carbohydrate content in the vegetables, fruits, milk, meat and grains, then first priority is the food. Food is the major source of carbohydrate, then vegetables are also good source, then grains, then milk and lastly the wheat and beans. Food source of fiber, grains, rice and bran 1 cup, it shows 7.5. So this chart shows the grains, vegetables, fruits, meats and beans, food source of fiber. From grains, they provide the very good fiber. Then the fruits, then meat, and lastly the vegetables. Vegetables do not have the as such so much of fiber. Best source of carbohydrates are fresh fruits and vegetables. This summary: whole grains, legumes hain, low fat dietary products hain. Excellent source of fiber are whole grains. जो ग्रेन्स है वो बहुत अच्छा सोर्स है फाइबर का. फ्रूट्स हैं, लेग्यूम्स, वेजिटेबल्स, नट्स, सीड्स. पैकेज फूड कैन बी गुड सोर्स ऑफ स्टार्च एंड फाइबर्स. रीड लेवल केयरफुली, क्या है उसके अंदर. कार्बोहाइड्रेट ज्यादा तो नहीं है, शुगर एडेड नहीं है. अवॉइड टू मच ऑफ शुगर, फैट एंड दस वी कैन से किलो कैलोरीज. डायबिटीज मेलाइटस, देयर आर टू टाइप ऑफ डायबिटीज. One is the diabetes mellitus that is caused due to the deficiency of insulin. Whereas another type of diabetes, that is diabetes insipidus, that is caused due to the deficiency of ADH. In diabetes insipidus, there is no glucose level is increased. But in diabetes mellitus, glucose level is increased because it is caused due to the deficiency of insulin or working up, non-working of beta cells. Occurs when individual either doesn't make enough or is unable to utilize the hormone insulin to regulate blood glucose level. Epidemic, sixth leading cause of death in the United States. Cost United dollar 100 billions annually. Number of people with diabetes is rising annually. So this is alarming, the such a disease. Diabetes mellitus, consume carbohydrate, blood glucose level rises. Blood glucose rises, lower breakdown of glycogen and product and glucose from non-carbohydrate source. Ketoacidosis, body uses fats for fuel, cells are, so thus we can say that the symptoms of polydipsia, polyuria, ketoneuremia, these all are the symptoms of diabetes mellitus. Increase in the hyperglycemia, polydipsia, polyuria, ketoneuremia, these are the symptoms of diabetes mellitus. Form of diabetes, type 1, usually begins in childhood. Easily or early adulthood. 5-15% of diabetic. Immune system destroy beta cells of pancreas. No insulin is produced. This is type 1. Common symptoms of elevated blood sugar, polydipsia, bar bar pet lagna, polyuria, bar bar urination, polyphagia, bar bar bhook lagna. Requires insulin and frequent blood glucose monitoring. Diabetes type 2, overweight individual develop this form frequently. 90-95% of diabetics can go undiagnosed, damage the vital organs without individual being aware of it. Polycystic ovary syndromes, female hormonal imbalance in women, have higher incidence of insulin resistance and hyperinsulinemia, increased risk of developing type 2. Form of diabetes, pre-diabetics, impaired glucose tolerance, fasting glucose sugar between 100 and 126, high risk of developing diabetics and heart disease. Diabetes, long-term damage of diabetes, tooth loss, gums, problems, kidney disease, heart disease, long-term damage of diabetics, nerve damage, leg and foot amputations, eye disease, blindness. These are the symptoms of diabetes. Slowing of onset of complications, control level of blood glucose through the diet, insulin or oral medications, monitoring blood glucose level, regular health visit. Diabetes, slowing up onset of complication, control level of blood glucose through the diet, insulin or oral medication, monitoring blood glucose, regular health care visit. red flags for type 2 diabetes in children and adolescent. The following risk factors may increase the risk of childhood diabetes 2 in the children and adolescent: being overweight, second, any two of the following, having a parent or grandparent with type 2 diabetes, being of American, Indian, African, American, Hispanic, American, Asian, American, Pacific, Islander descent, slowing signs of being resistant to insulin, or having conditions associated with insulin resistance, such as high blood pressure, or too much of fat or cholesterol in the blood, and polycystic ovary syndrome. Quick review. Diabetes involves inadequate regulation of blood glucose level. Type 1 diabetes, inadequate production of insulin. Type 2 diabetes, insulin resistance. In this, the production may be chronic high blood glucose, can be damaged vital organs. Diabetics needs medications and are insulin to manage the blood glucose level. High fiber diet and routine exercise plays a key role in managing and preventing diabetes. Polycystic ovary syndromes increases the risk of developing type 2 diabetes. So thus we have completed the absorption as well as the certain disease like diabetes mellitus. Next time we will study the other diseases like hypoglycemia.